It's probably just lack of practice, but my freehand die threading has always been a little bit hit and miss, so I've been keeping my eye open for a tailstock die holder. For some reason that now completely escapes me, shortly after getting my lathe, I got it into my head that I really needed a Morse taper extension sleeve. In all honesty, I don't remember ever using it. It's just sat around gathering dust. Now, if you've seen some of my other builds, you'll know that I like to incorporate bits of other things into my projects. The time and effort involved usually outweighs any financial saving in materials, but I reckon reusing where you can isn't a bad philosophy. I spied an old gas regulator in the scrap bin, and it gave me an idea. I reckoned the top half would be a good starting point for that tailstock die holder. I unscrewed the cap and mounted it in the lathe. I wanted to enlarge the bore to take my MT2 sleeve, which has a 1-inch OD. I began by opening out the hole in the end with a twist drill. And once the hole was big enough, I switched to a boring bar. Using a mirror, I checked the depth and set the tool holder so it would hit the work before the tool hit the chuck. I know my headstock alignment needs a coat of looking at because I'm turning slight tapers, so I stopped about 0.25mm short of my target. I'd take the tube to final dimension with an adjustable reamer. The reaming took several passes, a small cut, measure, rinse and repeat. Eventually, I got a nice fit. Then I swapped the part over to remove the gas regulator threads. Next, I chucked a piece of 2-inch steel and faced the end. Initially, turning the diameter was pretty chattery, so I added some support. It was much improved afterwards. The bar was turned down to be an easy fit in the brass housing. Here's a little tip. I keep some Dichem layout fluid in an old nail varnish bottle. I find the little brush is better for small parts, and it means when it gets knocked over, the biggest puddle that I can make is about 20mm. I mark the end, ready to make a 1-inch die-sized hole. I was struggling to part the end off, so once I got a guide groove, I finished it off with a hacksaw. Which meant it had to go back in the lathe to be tidied up. So far, so good. I wanted a pair of screw holes diametrically opposite to join the brass outer and the steel inner. To avoid any misalignment, I thought I'd drill them at the same time, but I couldn't face digging out the rotary table and setting it up, so I cobbled together a fixture from a square collet block and some other junk. After finding the edge and moving to the centre of the steel ring, I drilled through 5mm, ready to tap M6. I also added a flat spot to each side with a slot drill. I dismantled the assembly and squared up the ring in the vise, ready to tap. Another little tip is to apply cutting fluid from these little bottles to avoid wasting it. They come in handy for all kinds of things. I'd need fixing holes at 45 degree increments to cover all the solid and split dies that I currently have, and it turns out that I may as well have dug out the rotary table in the first place. I cobbled together another fixture, mounted the part and drilled 4.2mm holes ready to tap M5. Looking back at this footage, I think a machinist jack wouldn't have gone amiss to help with the flex on my little rotary table. Once the holes were drilled, I went round again with a tap. The collar would now hold a die in place. The last job was to make a set of screws and handles to fix the collar to the brass outer. First, I modified a pair of button head screws. Then I made a short handle. I turned down a piece of rod and threaded the end. This would have been easier with a tailstock die holder. Oh, wait a minute. I added a little taper and tidied up the end. Everything looked okay, so I set off and made a matching pair. Finally, I made a slightly longer handle. Once cut to length, I reduced the end to take a Delrin sleeve so the long bar can rest against the lathe bed without any damage. And that's pretty much it. For small stuff, I can use the button head screws for no stick out and use the hand clutch to power thread. Or I can rest the long handle against the bed and power thread. Or run the chuck by hand. And finally, if I lock the chuck, I can use the two smaller handles to rotate the die. Clearly, dies come in different sizes, but most of mine are 1 inch and cover all the sizes that I'm likely to try and cut using this method. If that changes, it will just be a case of making up another steel adapter ring to suit. I guess that's it for this one. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments, and hopefully I'll see you next time.